Came here in 1969. Fortunately for me, Don Dunstan really liked my paintings, and they were looking for somebody to paint a mural down here. It's the last of what I call the motorbike paintings. I had this quick bike, used to dash through the landscape, and I just liked the sea, and it was very pleasant at the end of a day's work to experience that coast ride and to start the day's work with the coast ride. And this mural is a accumulation of what I call sliding glances. And you get a complex of shapes. And doing that over a period of time, I had this fairly well cemented in my head. My paintings are not of a subject, they're about a subject. You put marks down and you build on it and build on it and build on it. And my head fills up with a whole lot of images. It was done fairly quickly. All those images were there. The verticals look strange, but if you look at those obliques, you'll find the reminiscent of gum trees. You can see the shapes of bark that you find in a gum tree, but they're reduced to their simplest form, so they become part of the structure of the whole. There's the sea and the wind, the freshness of landscape. To me, there's a great deal of reality there, perhaps not to the viewer, yeah. If it was taken apart, you would find that all those panels are reasonably complete. They started off all individually painted and then putting them together, then finishing it off to tie the whole thing in. So it's again like a visual poem, verse after verse after verse, line after line after line. I'm really pleased with it. I expect to see a lot of struggle there. But examining it this morning, it seems to hang together. If you could look at it as a visual poem that needs understanding, and you can only get from it the interpretation that the viewer views it, that has its own answers. To me, it's a series of glorious motorbike rides. ¶¶